Greetings! I am Herbert Erpoderp, and today I'm going to build these plastic 15mm scale SDKFZ250ALT half-tracks from Plastic Soldier Company. The back of the box has some images of the vehicle in two colour schemes, and a relatively in-depth painting guide, at least for the back of a box anyway. Inside the box we find this instruction leaflet with a parts guide that clearly indicates which parts are required for each of the five variants of this half-track this kit can be used to make. The reverse side has all the instructions. They're fairly basic, but easy enough to understand and follow. The five sprues in the box are all fairly neat and did not have much in the way of mold lines. Unsurprisingly, there are a lot of parts for all the variants you can build, including quite a lot of figures. The unused ones could be handy for use with other models or on dioramas. After some consideration, I've decided to build the plain old troop carrier version. I start the build by gluing the two parts of the lower hull together. Be sure you press these parts together firmly or your mudguards will be too low. I found this out the hard way on one vehicle. Next, I glue the tracks into place. These parts are quite neat and didn't need a lot of cleanup. If only all Plastic Soldier Company track sets were like this. The parts are keyed to help with positioning the tracks, which is always nice. The axle part for the front wheels is then glued into place. I didn't bother cleaning the mold lines off this part as it won't really be visible. The wheels come next, obviously. No keying on these and they don't fit tightly to the axle, which I think is good. It allows you to position them on angles as though they're steering. Still, be careful to get them aligned neatly with each other and the body of the vehicle. Now for some internal details. Glue in the front floor and transmission piece. And then the passenger bench and what appears to be some kind of storage box. Then the driver is glued into place. I would prefer to paint him separately, but I figured it would be too tricky to get him into the assembled vehicle once he was painted. He won't be too visible, so he doesn't need a detailed paint job anyway. Next, I glue the upper hull onto the lower hull. Pretty simple, the parts fit quite nicely. Be sure to wipe away any excess glue that spills from the join. Here's something I quite liked, this rack of jerry cans. It comes as three parts that need to be glued together. Having this detail come in three parts rather than one single piece allows more realistic looking depth between the jerry cans. At least that's what I imagine the designer's reasoning was. Either way, they look good. Glue them to the back of the hull. There's nothing to guide correct positioning here, but it isn't hard to get them straight. Now for some armament. I glue in the rear-mounted machine gun, and then the gun shield for the forward-facing gun. The forward-facing gun itself comes with a figure holding it, so we'll add that later. Next we add what I believe to be the exhaust system, or some kind of stowage with vents on the left side of the half-track, and then a storage box on the right side. I then close the gaping hole in the front of the vehicle by gluing on the frontal armor. The half-track is now complete. Almost. We do still need crew. Glue together the crewman operating the forward-facing machine gun. The parts fit together quite nicely. I then just place him inside the half-track. He won't be glued in until he is painted. This will make the task of painting both man and vehicle much easier. The same goes for this binocular-wielding crewman, and the sitting ones. That's about all there is to it. Of course, there are four other variants to build, and while I didn't put any of those together, I would imagine they're just as easy to assemble as this troop carrier version. Unfortunately, I don't have any other SDKFZ250s to compare this with, but judging by pictures, this looks much better than Battlefront's version. This is quite a nice kit, which I've come to expect from Plastic Soldier Company. There is usually quite a few options and variations included with their kits, which I really enjoy. My bits box also enjoys Plastic Soldier Company. The instructions, while not quite as comprehensive as those by Rubicon, are still quite clear and adequate. At least you don't have to go online to get them. The parts were very neat and didn't need a lot of cleanup, which meant I was able to build these models rather quickly. If you're looking for a small half-track for your Germans to cruise around the battlefield in, I would definitely recommend these Plastic Soldier Company models. I probably won't be painting these anytime soon, but eventually, one day, I will, and I think they'll look pretty great when they're painted up. What do you think of these? I'd love to see any comments you have in the comments section below, or perhaps on one of the social media places that I've linked in the description. As always, do things like clicking like or subscribing if you want to see more. Thanks for watching. Farewell.